It's no secret, both inside and outside the palace, that the Crown Prince, Li Jiancheng, is at odds with the Prince of Qin, Li Shimin, and recent events have exacerbated the tension. As the Emperor, Li Yuan is disturbed by their open struggle over who will be next to occupy the throne. As a father, he naturally doesn't want to see his sons end up in a deadly struggle for the throne, as has often happened in history. Li Yuan, who ascended to the throne just 8 years ago, is determined to resolve the dispute this very morning. One of his sons had killed two other sons. This is known in Chinese history as the Xuanwu Gate Incident. The friction between the Prince of Qin, Li Shimin, and the Crown Prince, Li Jiancheng, ended in a brutal tragedy that bloody morning. It was the last thing the Emperor ever wanted to see. And with both regret and panic, he thought about all the things he still wanted to do and what he wanted to say to them. But now, it was too late. Upheavals rarely happen spontaneously. Everything that happened that morning was according to a plot that began brewing 9 years earlier. In early May of the year 617, the meeting would not only impact his family, but also the whole of China for three centuries. Towards the end of the Sui Dynasty, the rule of Emperor Yang was brutal, and the nation was in chaos as warlords emerged all over the country. The Sui Dynasty was doomed. Li Yuan, who inherited the title of Duke of Tang from his father when he was just 7 years old, came to a crucial juncture, whether to stay loyal to the Sui dynasty or rebel like the others. During the meeting, Li Yuan's 18-year-old son Li Shimin became the strongest supporter for a military revolt.
这两趟车都讲哈，这个睢阳起兵主要是李世民在那操作。李世民怎么操作的呢？李世民他主要是跟一个叫刘文静的一个人在操作。他们做了很多事情，比方说去跟那个裴寂，就是他爸爸的好哥们儿，当时的晋阳公监，让刘文静他去赌钱，赌钱赌输了，再劝说裴寂，让裴寂再去劝李渊。这是一件事儿，还有一件事儿呢，更做的更损，说让裴寂给李渊提供了好多美女，其实这些美女呢都是晋阳宫的宫女。 本来应该是给隋炀帝准备的，那你李渊这个就是犯了欺君大罪了，逼他起兵，这样几件事呢，凑到一块儿就给人一种印象，说李世民才是操盘手，李渊呢是在儿子的这个逼迫之下不得不起兵的。In
both chronicles of the Tang Dynasty, Li Yuan is described as a strong-willed and straightforward person who treated people with mercy and tolerance. He was sincere, and he followed his heart. All the warlords around Taiyuan believed that Li Yuan would be a good emperor, calling him a talent to bring order to the world, a king to dispel chaos. But there are contradictions in those same books. Even right up to the last moment when he decided to rebel against the Sui regime, the recorded actions of the ambitious Li Yuan made him seem indecisive. He was strangely hesitant.
李渊虽然这个时候已经是三品高官，又是这个一等爵，但是实际上他早年有很多的不幸之事，比如说他很早他母亲就去世了，那就是几岁以前就去世了，至少他父亲在他七岁的时候也去世了，所以那个时候他七岁的时候就成为一个彻底的孤儿，因为他姨是这个独孤皇后嘛，所以他呢也经常被他姨接到这个宫里面去生活，他跟隋炀帝从小在一块玩的，双方关系很亲密嘛，隋炀帝比李渊小两岁。
As a childhood playmate and cousin of the emperor, Li Yuan was caught in a dilemma. He fondly recalled growing up together as part of a family, making it unthinkable to harm his cousin. But on the other hand, the fall of the Sui dynasty was a foregone conclusion. It was only a matter of time before someone else took the throne. As a matter of fact, Li Yuan had considered rebellion against the Sui regime even before he became the rear officer of Taiyuan. But there was too much he couldn't do just by himself.
我们在历史上一直看到李世民在那上蹿下跳，哈，急交这个人，急交那个人，给这个赔祭花钱，给这些这个侵犯的花钱，钱哪来的？李世民当时是一个18岁的少年，他的钱只有一个来路，就是他爸爸那儿。 他爸爸给他钱，让他去结交四方英雄，所以为什么说李渊深谋远虑、老谋深算？他自己方便不方便出马？绝不方便出马，让他们在外面替他活动，最后形成一股势力。他在这个势力充分成熟的情况下，再去领兵打仗。
On May the 15th of the same year, Li Yuan plotted to kill the man sent by Emperor Yang to spy on him. This was his first step towards the throne. But as yet, he still hadn't announced his intention to rebel. This was because, as the chief military and administrative officer of Shanxi, Li Yuan had to leave behind most of his family in Hedong, which at the time was still under the Sui dynasty. Li Yuan was a strong family man. He knew he had to transfer his family to safety in Jinyang before launching any rebellion. Li Yuan's first son by his first wife, Li Jiancheng, now 28 years old, was put in charge of the escape. He was the man of the house in Hedong while his father was away. Before Li Yuan's rebellion, the whole family, led by Li Jiancheng, clandestinely traveled a great distance to reach Jinyang. The way was full of danger and hardships. And during one of the journeys, one of Li Jiancheng's younger brothers died. In June of 617 AD, Li Yuan announced his rebellion in Jinyang, the first step in his efforts of Li's family to unify the empire.
Ah, 霍华当时经过几次大战。
军队不能派两个领导， 任何时候都是一样的，是军队最讲究一元化指挥了，对不对？所以这个看起来一定是李建成是指挥，李世民也参与了，也去了，也算是领导人之一，可能是这样。但是真正的指挥一定是李建成。李建成是长子，是李渊的长子，李世民的哥哥，年纪很大，所以呢，他实际上一直充当着这样的一种角色，就是在他父亲不在的时候，他是事实上的家长。
In 618 AD, 2 years after the Jinyang Rebellion began, Li Yuan officially became the first emperor of the Tang Dynasty in Chang'an, now known as Xi'an, and he chose Wu De as his throne name. Naturally, Li Yuan's oldest son, Li Jiancheng, long acting as head of the family, became the crown prince. But Li's reign was still far from the later glory days of the famous Tang Dynasty. The demise of the Sui Dynasty had left behind a broken state divided among competing warlords. The Tang Dynasty was then just one among many competing forces in the region, one that could be wiped out at any moment. In addition, there were some obscure and subtle changes taking place within the new regime. Li Yuan's second year was plagued by a...
就是在家里面骂裴寂，然后他甚至拔刀击柱，把刀拔出来在家里面乱砍，然后说我一定要早晚杀掉这个老家伙，就杀掉裴寂。结果这话呢就被他的一个小妾给听见了，他就把当作重要证据，把这个事情讲给他哥哥，然后让他哥哥赶快到朝廷里面去报告，说这个刘文静要谋反，要杀宰相，你看这事不严重了吗？
As Liu Wenjing's former superior, Li Shimin pleaded with Li Yuan to give Liu another chance in consideration of his assistance during the rebellion. But history doesn't record how Crown Prince Li Jiancheng felt about this incident.
皇上也一定会跟太子商量的，这是一个很大的事情啊，对不对？这太原起兵的功臣，你现在说他谋反，这会影响很大的。那最终的结果呢，是皇帝杀掉了刘文静。这杀了，那肯定是，你看皇帝是同意杀才能杀，对不对？那裴寂是支持的，李世民是反对的，太子什么态度？没看见，没看见记录。但是我现在估计，
early summer of the year 624 AD, Emperor Gaozu Li Yuan was at a summer resort at Yuhua Mountain with his concubines and courtiers. Meanwhile, Crown Prince Li Jiancheng was handling political and military affairs as interim regent. This was a valuable internship for Li Jiancheng, who was to one day ascend to the throne. But just as Li Yuan was enjoying the cool breeze at Yuhua Mountain with his beautiful women, two messengers brought him terrible news. The news was that the crown prince and the governor of Qingzhou, Yang Wengan, were plotting rebellion and arranging for delivery of armor.
送铠甲这个事儿合不合理？这个事情其实是不合理的，就是按照唐朝的法令。是不可以这样做的，因为这是皇帝才可以决定一些武器的运输、军力的调动等等。啊，太子监国期间有皇帝在，他应该请示皇帝再做。
传宰相裴寂即刻觐见。
The Yang Wengan incident is described in the New Book of Tang. Li Jiancheng was jealous of Li Shimin, so he made a bold move. When Li Yuan went to the Renzhi Palace with Li Shimin for the summer, Li Jianchang took the opportunity to ask Yang Wengan, governor of Qingzhou, to recruit an army for him to stage a coup. But some of Li Jianchang's subordinates in charge of delivering the armor were afraid of the emperor's wrath, and they went to Yuhua Mountain to tip the emperor off. Li Yuan was furious. He summoned Li Jianchang, who admitted what he'd done.
Fu Huang, 儿臣知错了。就算是只身来到父皇面前谢罪。谢的是什么罪？其实谢的就是私下结交军将的罪，而且谢罪的态度特别诚恳，诚恳到什么程度？他磕头，但是他不是我们一般的安安稳稳跪在地下磕头，而是扑倒在地，然后拿那个头撞地板。所以当时史书记载的是，他差点就把自己给撞死。
父皇，儿臣虽有私欲甲胄之罪，但实无谋反之心啊！
逆子，你让朕好生失望啊！身为太子，竟然谋反，你好糊涂啊！
After detaining Li Jianchang, Li Yuan sent an emissary to investigate Yang. After his meeting with the emissary, Yang suddenly rebelled. The accusation that the crown prince was plotting rebellion was well-founded. Li Yuan immediately arranged to quell the rebellion. He ordered Li Shimin to be in charge of the specific task of putting down the rebellion, emphasizing that he was to personally lead his troops.
Urgent.拜见父皇。
起来吧。
谢父皇。
朕欲派你前去讨伐逆贼，如何？
父皇，杨文干之辈敢为狂逆，其属下本该将其就地擒之。若非如此，派一将领讨之即可，无需儿臣出马。
不可，杨文干之事，太子难脱干系，恐应之者助。由你亲自挂帅出征，何愁平叛无功？若得胜归来，立你为太子。
他跟李世民做了一个许诺，说你去平定杨文干，你去平定完杨文干，我把太子给你做。把太子给你做，而且还考虑了后事，就是把太子给你做之后，李建成去怎么办？
朕不是隋文帝，做不出自诛其子的事来。当封建成为蜀王，他日苟能弑汝，汝宜全之；不能弑汝，汝取之一耳。
啊，儿臣领旨。
Li Shimin set off to realize his great ambitions. And as it turned out, the rebellion was unexpectedly easy to quell. Yang Wengan was soon killed by a subordinate. It took Li Shimin just 4 days to completely put down this illogical rebellion. But when he triumphantly returned, he found that he was still Prince of Jin, and Li Jiancheng was still the Crown Prince. What puzzled Li Shimin even more was that Li Yuan not only broke his promise to make him the Crown Prince, but did not punish Li Jiancheng. Instead, the emperor simply exiled many counselors and followers of the prince. Li Shimin was astonished to find that on the list of exiles, in addition to the Crown Prince's allies, was Du Yan, an important counselor of his. Li Yuan's seemingly illogical management of the Yang Wengan incident has long been cited as key evidence of incompetence.
如果我们从现有的这个记载来看，错在哪儿？一定是错在李建成啊！你首先你送盔甲是错的，另外你的这个亲信吧，在造反，那就是更加错，错上加错。为什么后来李渊又各打五十大板，而且就没有兑现他在之中给李世民的那个承诺？
当然，从史料记载来说，好像是李渊是耳根子软。本来答应了，然后经过嫔妃的这个说啊，他最后又放弃了，还是没有让李世民当太子。但是这个肯定不完全是事实。
There are a number of things in the official historical records about the Yang Wengan incident that are questionable. First of all, the Crown Prince and Yang seem to have been plotting rebellion for some time.But even after their plot was exposed, the Crown Prince went to see his father when ordered to do so. Even Yang Wengan had the determination and courage to fight, while the prince just surrendered without resistance. Secondly, even if the Crown Prince did deliver the armor without permission, it was possible that he meant to give the armor to some generals as a reward for their service. Though it was illegal, it made sense and did not necessarily indicate a connection between delivering the armor and a rebellion. Finally, it seems odd that the Crown Prince, as the legal heir to the throne,should stage a rebellion. It would seem there must have been a motive.
《新唐书》里，李建成传里的这么一句话，就是当时他为什么要动手？他说了这么一段话，他就说，因为秦王啊，他到处是贿赂这个嫔妃，那我不能坐受其祸，所以呢，安危之计决在今日，说了这么一句话。那就从这句话看呢，他倒反而是受害者，他不能坐受其祸，所以他要安危之计决在今日。可是自中间在取这句话的时候，把前段话删了，只是说李建成说安危之计决在今日，这就很奇怪。所以这个整个事情是比较还是不太清楚。我觉得不清楚最主要是他谋反干嘛？他是要针对着李世民，还是针对谁？还是要干嘛？他其实没有道理的。
If Li Jiancheng really didn't intend to rebel, then what were the actual circumstances he faced during the Yang Wengan incident?
Yang Wengan 如
果真是他跟杨文干勾结要叛乱，这里头真有他的事儿的话，他是不敢去见李渊的。
这可如何是好？
是啊，
圣上已知晓此事，
圣上是怎么知道的？
这，
哎呀！
也罢，父皇既然召见，
负荆请罪便是。
太子，
太子不可啊！
太子，不可！太子怎么能？
Li Jianchang made the right decision at this critical moment. The Tang Dynasty had only been established for a few years, and the country was only recently unified. Li Jianchang, who begged forgiveness, threw himself into this tornado because there was one thing he could not fully explain.
圣上口谕，圣上问你知罪否？
儿臣虽有私运甲胄之罪，但实无谋反之心啊。
圣上再问你，既无谋反之心，杨文干如今为何起兵造反？
什么？杨文干反了？儿臣不知啊。
Yang's rebellion has long been a mystery. He was once a guard in the Eastern Palace who was loyal to the Crown Prince. But at this critical junction, his actions expose Li Jianchang to mortal danger.
这个朝廷派宇文颖去了解杨文干的事儿，看看到那去看看虚实，就到那呢。杨文干果然就谋反了，就起兵了。他起兵明显的是对太子不利，他不该起兵，他只要起兵，那就是成了太子的事情。那可是他为什么又要起兵呢？这跟宇文颖的这个状态应该有关系，就是他到了杨文干了说了什么话。
There is no record of what Yuan Ying said to Yang. Yuan Ying's fate is just as mysterious. After Yang rebelled, Yuan Ying, emissary of the emperor, joined the rebel army. However, it's unclear just how voluntary his actions were.It's not clear whether Li Yuan or Li Shiming ordered the execution of Yuan Ying. And the subject of his meeting with Yang will never be known.
史书没记载，那一定是他说了一些话激起了杨文干的叛乱。那大概就是会说什么样的话会激起杨文干的叛乱呢？
我想杨文干和李建成的关系应该是非常好的，或者说他曾经在东宫干过，他要效忠东宫的嘛。那你去带个话让杨文干来把这个李建成救出来，那他去到那儿去说了，就说了这些话。那杨文干听了以后就对他起兵了，他起兵的目的并不是要谋反。
Little is recorded about Yuan Ying in contemporary records. In fact, we don't even know when he was born.Although historians regarded him as an insignificant figure at the time, he might well have been directly responsible for mobilizing the army. Perhaps he was behind an even bigger plot. In the new book of Tang, we find the following about the Yang Wengan incident. Yuan Ying was close to Li Yuanji, which is why he influenced Yang's plans. This shows.That Yuan Ying seemed to have been close to Li Yuanji. The man who sent Yuan Ying to persuade Yang to rebel was actually the Prince of Qi, Li Yuanji.
这史书上呢，也是有记载的，就是要加强，李元吉的罪行。所以呢，说李元吉啊有自己的计划，他就挑拨这俩兄弟俩的关系，最好呢，让这个。太子杀掉秦王，杀掉秦王以后，他再去杀掉太子，然后他就稳朝胜券了。 啊，这是他的计划，史书也是这么写的，《资治通鉴》啊什么都有这个写法，但是这个也很有可能是后来的一种写法，就是因为这涉及到一个一连串的动机问题。
Li Yuanji was the youngest of the three sons of Li Yuan's first wife, but because of his quick temper, his father never really cared for him. Li Yuanji had long been a political ally of the crown prince. It doesn't seem likely that this prince would want to frame his closest ally, especially when Li Shimin was still alive. With his limited political power, Li Yuanji alone could clearly not compete with Li Shimin in a struggle for the throne. But there was someone else who could have encouraged Yu Wenying.
就是说，这件事情完了以后，处罚了三个人，其中两个人是东宫的官员，这个没有问题啊，东宫的官员处罚，还有一个是李世民的官员，天策府的官员。就是为什么要处罚这个天策府的官员，就是杜淹啊，这是非常蹊跷的。因为杜淹这个人啊，是一个非常奸猾的人，就是史料记载，就是说他当时是本来他是想投靠李建成的，然后被房玄龄发现了，房玄龄呢就告诉当时的吏部，就主管部，等于是现在主管干部的这一个官员，就跟他说不要让他去李建成那，然后跟太宗说你要把他收回来。为什么不愿意让他去李建成呢？就因为杜渊这个人诡计多端。
After the rebellion was put down, Li Yuan exiled Du Yan without giving a reason. Li Shimin gave Du a huge reward before he was exiled.Perhaps as compensation. The amount was so large that people naturally questioned Li Shimin's motives.
在《杜淹传》里头写到哈，太宗知其非罪，就秦王啊知其非罪，在他流放的时候送了他300两黄金。300两黄金可是一个非常大的数字。如果他不是立了特别大的功的话，唐太宗不会给他这么多的奖赏，等于是重赏了。
The record is fairly silent about Li Yuan's activities between the time Li Shimin went to put down the rebellion and when he returned in triumph. The emperor clearly promised to make Li Shimin the crown prince, but he went back on his promise without explanation when the rebellion was in fact defeated. Obviously.Something happened during this period, something to make this strong-willed and straightforward emperor change his original plan.
受太子之命，
这个事情的真相应该是在唐太秦王前去镇压的时候，那在这个人质宫，大家才把这个情况搞清楚，搞清楚，太子是冤枉，太子是送盔甲不假，但是没有叛乱的问题，那个所以总体上是冤枉了。秦王府看起来是没什么事情，其实背后是都是他们鼓捣的，杜淹一定是参与了这个事情。所以包括东宫的人上告，这可能都是杜淹背后在做导演。
朕素以宽厚待人，然狂言欺上之徒概不在此列，尔等可还记得刘文静乎？背后究竟有无旁人之事？
Du would have prompted Yu Wenying to trick Yang Wengang into rebellion by telling him that he was saving the crown prince. Finally, Li Xiumin would emerge as the hero who put down the rebellion, during which he would kill Yu Wenying to ensure secrecy. The final outcome would be the promise from his father to make him crown prince.
This thing, 应该是秦王府发动的一次攻击，攻击性行为，其实就是希望把太子引向叛乱的这条路上去。
太子在这里很可能是被冤枉的，被谁冤枉的？被李世民冤枉的。但是你虽然说被李世民冤枉的，可是呢，真实的证据可能也很难抓出来，从李渊的角度也很难抓出来。而且李世民带兵平定杨文干叛乱，这仍然是立了功的。所以最后的解决方式是什么？是各打五十大板，两个人的手下都有不对的地方。那李世民他手下的一个叫杜淹的人也因此就遭到了贬斥。
It should be mentioned that there are few details in the record of the Yang Wengang incident in the Old Book of Tang, which was written several centuries later in the Jin Dynasty. All the known details about the incident.Come from the few lines in the New Book of Tang and comprehensive mirror to aid in government.
确实是一个很重视感情、重视亲情、愿意把身边所有人都能安置好的这样的一个人。所以实际上，后来为什么一定会激发出玄武门之变？我想根子在他这儿。他呢，愿意维护稳定，愿意维护这个李建成的太子之位。但与此同时，他内心可能又真的是觉得李世民这儿功高难赏啊，他的儿子真的那么优秀啊，那么了不起啊？你说去打击他，于心何忍呢？打击谁都是手心手背，手心手背。你这样想来想去，最后缔造的就是这两个人的冲突越来越激化，越来越激化。
How will Li Jiancheng retaliate against Li Shimin's attack? Now accused of poisoning his brother, can Li Jiancheng earn back the trust of his father? Li Jiancheng is described in history as profligate and devoid of principles, but was this really true? Join us for the next part, in which we will reveal the truth about Crown Prince Li Jiancheng and the last 72 hours of his life.